everyone. It's Grant, and I just want to say thank you to all of you who have been supporting this channel for a while. I've been doing this whole YouTube thing for really kind of over a year or so, and not really taking it seriously, and so I want to put together some content for you guys because it's been really fun and I enjoyed doing it. So thank you for your support. If you're brand new to this channel, if you're not even subscribed, make sure you subscribe. But today I want to talk about my story. I want you guys to know exactly who I am, kind of how I got into fishing and my life experiences up until this point. So when I was about 5 or 6 years old, I saw a guy out at a lake. We were out there for some reason, me and my family. And I saw a guy that was using topwater frogs, and we all love frog fishing, right? Like, you absolutely love to see huge bass blow up on these topwater lures. Up until that point, I really had never been into fishing, and so I saw this guy throwing these moss frogs on top of the moss, and the bass just coming up and blowing up on these things. And as a 5 or 6 year old kid, that was like one of the coolest things that I had ever seen. Like, I mean, if you guys can remember to when you very first started fishing, like, what got you into fishing? You know, and that for me was like, wow, that is just unbelievable. And up until that point, like, I liked wildlife, like, I was intrigued with fish and everything like that. But man, that just put it over the top where I'm just like, man, I have to get into fishing. And so I did. Like, when I was 6 or 7 years old, I went out and I bought a fishing pole, a little spinning rod or open face reel, whatever one I got, and I started to fish. I absolutely loved it. And then when I turned like 9 or 10 years old, I remember getting a bait caster for the very first time. And it was just the coolest thing. It took me a long time to really get the hang of a bait caster, especially at 9 or 10 years old. But I was able to do it. And so from that point on, I was absolutely determined that I was gonna be a professional bass fisherman, like, just determined. And so everything that I would do would be, man, I gotta get better at casting, I gotta get better at this and this and this and this, because, you know, as a 10-year-old kid, I'm like, I am going to be on the Bassmaster circuit someday. And so that was my goal. And so I loved fish, and I loved just working on casting, and I loved going to new rivers and new lakes and trying to fish as much as I possibly could. It was just a passion, and it still is a passion. It was a passion to go fishing and catch a lot of bass, and really just for the sport of it. Like, I never really got into eating fish. It was more, you know, seeing the bass masters and knowing that they released fish and they weighed them in and everything. And so it was really just the sport element, and it was something that I was really good at. And so I really enjoyed it. Well, fast forward a few years as I got into high school and junior high and high school, sports kind of became more of a focus. Even though I did a lot of fishing still, like, that became more of the focus. And so I ended up, you know, playing football, baseball, basketball, and I did track as well. And ended up being able to do well in football and play at the collegiate level, which was really fun. I got to play at a 2-year school right away. And then for about 8 months or so, I got to experience what it was like to play at a Division I level. And you know, I really didn't play, but I started in spring ball and played in spring ball. And then I ended up quitting before the fall. And that was still really cool. It was really an awesome experience. You know, looking back, I don't know if I should have quit, but if I didn't, then the next thing would have happened in my life. And as soon as I quit, I ended up starting a band, okay? I have always been into music. Like, I absolutely love music. As you could tell by the beginning of this video, you saw passions of mine. It's fishing, music. I love to snowboard. There's just so many things in my life that I absolutely love. And so, a lot of passions, and music was one of those. So when I was younger, I played guitar and I just wrote music here and there and everywhere. And so anyway, fishing and music and football and, you know, all of these different activities that I love to do. Well, I ended up starting a band, and it, you know, was like, hey, let's just start a band, see what happens. It was me and 4 other guys that just randomly started jamming out together. And what ended up being just guys that jammed out together turned into a record deal, and it turned into touring, and it was just amazing. In fact, you saw a little bit of the music video, and so here's part of the music video that you'll absolutely love if you're into that metal stuff. Check it out.
I
So that was part of my life for so long. Like, I think we were a band for 4.5, almost 5 years, and we toured full time for about 2 years. And so that was a huge blessing. Like, it was absolutely amazing. Loved to do it. And, you know, when the band was done, though, I still loved writing music, but I had forgotten about my passion of fishing. Like, I had really put it on the back burner during college sports, and even at the time I got married and I've got a beautiful wife, and now I have two beautiful daughters. You know, I told my wife, I said, hey, I actually have a passion to fish, and she had no idea that I absolutely loved fishing. And so when we moved to the Chicago area, I ended up getting back into fishing again. And it's just been a passion, a long lost passion that I absolutely love, because I put it on the back burner for so long with sports and music and so many other things. And so now, guys, I just absolutely love to fish. And so hopefully you guys can see my passion for fishing. Hopefully this channel is something that you guys can learn from, whatever it is. And, you know, there's still so much more to my story that I haven't shared, but that's kind of a glimpse of my background to where I am at now, where, you know, growing up, like, I fished all the conventional gear that I possibly could, obviously, like every single one of you. And then about 40 years ago, I started tossing big swim baits here in the Midwest. And I caught more big bass in the last probably 4 years. It was about 4 years ago when I started. I caught more big bass in the last 4 years than I had my entire life. And so now, you know, you'll see in some of my videos coming up that I don't just use big swim baits. Like, I'll use a lot of worms. I've been doing a lot of worm fishing lately, a lot of Senko fishing. But I just love tossing big swim baits now. And you don't really catch a lot of fish. If you guys are really familiar with the swim baits, you know about that. But you catch some big bass. And so, and big muskies and whatever it is. And so my goal this year is to catch as many big bass as I possibly can. It's to catch muskies, it's to catch northerns, and whatever's biting. Like, I don't just want to be a one species fisherman. Like, I want to be a multi-species guy. And so you see a lot of my videos this year, I'll be going after so many different types of fish that like big baits, you know. And so I'm going to give it a shot, guys. I just moved to Minnesota from Illinois, and so there's a lot of lakes, plenty of opportunities, and I'm really excited about that. But thank you guys once again, and I really want you to be a part of this channel as much as you possibly can. Give me input, talk to me, comment, everything, because I want us to have a fun year together. And so, guys, thank you once again for the support. Got some videos coming out here in the near future, and so be looking out for those. So make sure you guys talk to me, ask me any questions, and I want this to be a channel that's not about me tossing big baits, but it's about us. Like, it's about you guys as well. And so let's talk, let's have fun, let's have a great year, and let's make it happen.